Hello everyone and welcome back to another Star Wars action figure review. Today I got for you the Black Series 6-inch Jango Fett. Now, before I begin the review, if you see this guy, grab him. I mean, it's really hard to find more than one usually. And the only reason I was able to get this one was because of a dear friend of mine. You know who you are, and if you're watching, big thumbs up to you, man. Thank you so much for giving me the chance to get this guy. With that said, let's go ahead and start the review, shall we? The detailing and the overall sculpt is just magnificent. Perfect. This A+. I mean, they really did a nice job on him. One thing I really do like is that his armor is like a battle damaged or scuffed look. And it's not perfect, so yeah, that's really one thing I like. And the other thing I like is that his jumpsuit is not too purpley. Usually with the 3-inch figures, it looks too purple. So with this, perfect. Now here is Jango compared to his son Boba. And what really surprised me was they used a whole new mold for Jango. Instead of being like, oh, we already have a Mandalorian, let's just make Boba, repaint him, and call him Jango. No, they gave us a whole new figure, and just, if you're watching Hasbro, thank you so much for giving us a whole new figure instead of just being cheap and giving us a repaint. Accessories he comes with are actually quite a bit. Two of his trademark blaster pistols. They are a little bent, but not too bad. And you can fit them on either holster. They fit nice and snug. Now, the belt itself you probably could take off, except I'm not one of those people to try, so, sorry guys. Next, a removable jetpack. And it goes on with the peg at the bottom and the like two little things at the top. And it stays on nice and secure so you don't have to worry about it falling off. Last but not least, a removable helmet. Underneath you do have a pretty good head sculpt of the actor and of course the character. I think the eyebrows are a little messed up, but other than that, really good. And I'm very happy they decided to do a removable helmet rather than like two different heads. You pop one off, put the other one on. This, I think, is just more fun and, again, more easy. Seriously. Unfortunately, his rangefinder is stuck in place. You can't move it down. Then it's made of a soft plastic. And the only gripe I have with this whole figure, if you don't count the rangefinder, they don't give us the first jetpack we see. This is technically his second, because if you remember when he's battling Obi-Wan on Kamino, he has a different jetpack. Though yes, it was destroyed, but I would have liked to have seen them include that as well, besides just this. So, give us two. I mean, I can forgive it, but still, that's just me. And then when it comes to articulation, man, you're gonna have to bear with me, guys. This is quite a bit, and it's just great. He has a ball-jointed head, a hinge at the neck, ball-hinge shoulders, and right below that it swivels, ball-hinged elbows, and right below that it swivels again, ball-hinged wrists, like a ball-hinged or ball-jointed upper torso, ball-jointed hips, swivel thighs, double hinge knees, though it is a little bit hard on the top joint on both legs. And ball hinged swivel ankles. Packed with articulation. A little more than most, actually. And the only reason I think there's so many swivel joints on the arms is so that these hoses don't bend or anything. So, yeah, that's just my opinion. And like I say with most of my reviews, he does stand up well, it's just my cloth material background makes it hard for figures to stand up, so anytime you see him fall down, it's just because of the background. Here is the packaging he comes in. Well, guys, that's all the time I have for this Star Wars action figure review. Until next time, Admiral, alert my Star Destroyer to prepare for my arrival. And he just fell down.